Welcome in.
Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Nelly.
Mr. Nelly, Secretary of the Government, sir.
Oh, yes, sir.
And of course, you know.
We don't know this bad fellow.
Welcome back.
Mr. Nelly, the Secretary of the Government, Minister of Sullivan, the Foreign Minister Collins.
Prime Minister.
And the teacher.
Well, you see, the press will come in at 3 waves.
Waves of press.
You know, devastation here and right next door, nothing touched. They evidently kind of bounce. But then they were telling them point family. And, you know, it sucks the air out of the houses. The chair there. Oh, wait, oh, I know, you've got to wake them. This woman was in her house, she ran into her husband's arms. And it just literally sucked her right out of her arms and carried her clear out of the house. And the land here, she was hurt. The children the same way. And when he happened to be just in shorts, he ran to a, down to other people for help. They left him in clothing. He couldn't put it on because
he called him.
Say very seriously. It's a very religious day. But we might tell a joke or two later on. With the President's permission.
Morning, T-shirt. Morning, sir.
Morning.
What's that?
Expected. Same.
Why?
Just expected to smile. Not expected to say
anything. No. Make any profound statements.
What is the meaning of St. Patrick's Day, then?
It's a national feast day. St. Patrick is our national saint. And, on the 17th of March every year, we celebrate his feast day. And it's a religious occasion. St. Patrick came to Ireland in the year 432 and converted all the pagan Irish to Christianity. And we've been very good Christians ever since.
Most snakes, too.
Most of them. Well, I also banished the snakes from Ireland. Quite a considerable achievement.
You're Irish, Mr.
President.
You're Irish, Mr.
President. On my father's side. Yes.
State legislature is behind her.
Yes, because when part of the budget policy calls for a sizable program in turning back to the states programs and the tax resources paid that have been taken over recent decades by the federal government. Under our constitution, we feel those programs were always intended to be operated at the local and state level. And they're very enthused about it. They're driving most of the country. They want to do it.
They're glad to get these powers back in the states. And the funds, too.
What?
And the funds.
And the funds, yes. That's very important.
But when did that tend to...
Glory on,
and myself what a great honour and a privilege it's been for us to be invited today to the White House on such a wonderful occasion as this. And it's really fantastic, and we can only thank you most sincerely for the wonderful opportunity. And I'd like to end with one of my own favourites. It's a beautiful Irish love song, but I love singing this one, and it's called Mara My Girl.
Without one also.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have been hearing Frank Patterson and Haughey O'Grady in the heart of the piano, and in another part, in a major part of their lives, they are Mr. and Mrs. Frank Patterson. And they have their renown throughout Europe and our own country. They have recorded, if you're interested in hearing that again. I'm not only grateful to them for being here and giving of their wonderful talent to us, grateful that you sang this other song after Danny Boy, because if you stopped on Danny Boy, I wouldn't have been able to talk. So we're very in the audience here. But we're grateful to you, and we're honored by your presence. Thank you so very much.